Hello everyone, myself Alam, and this project is about composing and programming music in Python using EarSketch. So what is EarSketch? EarSketch is a free educational programming environment, and its core purpose and aim is to teach people coding in two widely used languages, Python and JavaScript, and it does not adopt a traditional way of teaching these languages. Rather, it adopts a very interesting way of teaching these languages, and that is through music composing and remixing. Now let's go ahead with our explanation slash exploring part of the EarSketch. First, we will go to the EarSketch official website. Okay, there you go. Click on the first link and you land on the official page. This is just a demo video. You just have to click on the get started button, and then you can create your account on the top right corner. Click on the create account button and then you register for the new account. Give a username, then a password. Okay, then you have to confirm your password. Okay, then you have to give your email and then press on create account. So our account has been created on this website, and now you can explore through some of its features if you want. Then let's say, for example, this keyboard button lets you know what all the shortcuts are present for this website. Like for save, you can use Control S, undo Control Z. These things are obvious ones. For comment, you can use control and backslash, sorry, the slash. To go to a line, you can use control plus L, and to complete a word, control plus space. And to run, you can use control enter. Let's see what this text is. Okay, you can set your font. Okay, then these are some other settings like switching your background color or reporting an error, etc. This is probably some reminder. Okay, yeah, there is no notification right now, so this is for notification, and this is my account. So let's observe few things first. This digital audio workstation is an audio workstation where you are going to see all the effects that has come on the audio you select. When you write the script on the editor just below this workstation. So let's explore some of the icons on the left extreme. The first icon that has already been clicked shows the list of soundtracks you have already. And also you can add your own sound browsing through your personal folders. Let's go to the second icon. Second icon lets you create a new script. If you already have an existing script, then you can have new scripts as well, or you can search for the scripts you have already created. Then the third icon lets you share the scripts you have written with the other people who are using EarSketch. And the fourth icon shows you the list of APIs, or you can say shows you the list of functions and the type of parameters they need to have. Let's say for Fit Media, you need to have file name, track number, start location, end location, etc., etc. So in short, there also effects you want to put on your audio. And the last one is about the tutorials for the people who are new to EarSketch. So now let's go ahead and create our first script. By clicking here, the first thing you do is write the name of your script. Let's go with music 55, and the type of script I choose is Python. You can also choose JavaScript, but let's go with Python first, and let's create our script. So now what you will see is our script has been created, and
when you press on this red cross, this script will get closed, and if you press on this blue plus, then you will be able to create new script. But we don't need that for now. Let's go to our script. So this is a Python type, so Python code. Our script name is music55. Author is obviously me. And let's name the description as Python and music. Okay. Now from ear sketch import star, like all the features of this ear sketch is imported. Init function allows you to initialize. Then this set tempo helps you to deal with the speed of the audio you select. Now let's load our audio. To load our audio, we will use fit media. Okay. And you can browse through this list and check what are the parameters for fit media. This one, fit media. Or I can do better, I can just remove this one and click on this icon to directly have it on my editor. So you can have it like this. So let's name our file. We will better load directly from the collection of our audiobooks. Let's go with this love beat first one. You can play and check what kind of beat or the soundtrack it is. I would rather jump that part and directly paste name of the audio track I want to load. Then the track number, let's make it the first track number. Start location or the first major, let's make it one itself. End location or the last major or the end major, let's make it 16. And this finish marks the end of your project. So let's run the script and check what happens. So I have pressed the run button. And on the workstation, you will see the effect dynamically of the script you have run. So what you see here, our script has been run and our output has been displayed on the workstation. And you can check out by playing this audio. Similarly, let's add one more audio track. So what we will do is we will copy this one and paste it on line 14. Then let's change a bit. The first parameter we have to change because we want another soundtrack. So let's replace this with, let's select second one, God is Love vocals. Let's select this one. Okay. So you can see, after clicking on this blue icon, my audio track name got pasted as the first parameter of fit media. Then this is a second track, so I will name this two and let it start with one and end with, let's say, 12. Okay, let's make it a little different. And obviously the 16th line will be finished. Now let's run the script. So I have run the script. So you can see our second media has been loaded in our workstation. Now we will check it by playing this audio. I went on and added the third audio track to my script, and you can see it with blue color at the workstation. Now what I will be doing is I will be doing some manipulations now. To do that, I have to come to the API list where you can find various functionalities. So we will go with set effect not this one, this is pretty long, lot of parameters. Let's go with this simple one. When I press this icon, you find that on the script you have it directly. This is a very amazing feature. Now you just have to put the parameters. This track is for the track number. Let's make it the 3, the latest audio track we have loaded to the script. Then the effect type I will be wanting is, you can have volume. Let's go with delay. This has to be capital, so I'll go with delay. And the effect parameter, let's make it delay time. So delay time, so this is the third parameter. And the effect value, let's go with 500, sorry. Okay, and obviously eventually we finish the script with finish, and then we run the script. So you can see the dynamic effect that has come to our workstation. Now let's play the sound and check it out.